verse, let's see, page number 11, lesson number 5, condemned to hell. So number one, a person must understand that they are personally condemned to hell before they can be saved. A person needs to understand that they are personally condemned to hell before they can be saved. Letter A. Up to this point, we have explained sin and the consequences for sin. So those are your fill in the blanks there. Up to this point, we have explained sin and the consequences for sin. Letter B. Now we will personalize it and make sure that they understand that they are personally condemned because of their sin. So here's what happens. You explain to someone the fact that they're a sinner, their sin has wages, which is death. It's not just a physical death, but the second death. You explain that to somebody, and in theory, they agree with you. And in theory, they say, oh yeah, all of that is right. But for some reason, people still don't personalize that. They don't say, well, I'm a sinner, and I deserve to go to hell. So the next step that we take is try to kind of personalize that for them. Point number two there, it says, it does not matter how good of a person you have been. It does not matter how good of a person you have been. Letter A, people like to think that they are not too bad. People like to think that they are not too bad. So we need to show them that they are. That's our goal, is to show them you are bad. So letter B, how this conversation may go. So what I would do is I would go to Revelation 21:8. Now if you remember, we left off in the book of Revelation already, Revelation 20, 14, and 15. So just moving over to Revelation 21:8. And usually I would read this verse. And the Bible says, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. And the way I would explain this verse is I would basically just point at the passage, and I would say something along those lines. I'd say, you know, in Revelation 21:8, the Bible actually gives us a list of people who are going to hell. Notice what it says. It says, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters. And then this is how I explain it. I just stop right there and I say, that's a pretty bad list, right? I mean, he's saying murderers, whoremongers, sorcerers, idolaters. And most people agree that a murderer is going to go to hell. You know, most people think like, oh yeah, a murderer will go to hell. And then I'll say, but look at the next thing. It says, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. And sometimes, you know, I kind of joke around with people. I say, let me ask you a question, all right? You got to be honest, okay? You can't lie to me, all right? Have you ever told a lie before? And of course, most people are going to say, yeah, you know, we've all lied. And the Bible says in Romans 3:4, it says, let God be true, but every man a liar. And I'll explain to them, see, what the Bible is saying here is that, you know, because in our minds, we like to justify ourselves. And we'll say things like, well, I'm not perfect, but I've never killed anyone, right? You know, I'm not as bad as so-and-so. And what the Bible is teaching here is that even a liar will go to hell. And the Bible says, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. So sometimes just the review question is as simple as, have you ever told a lie before? You know, because this verse applies to us there. If you turn the page to page number 12, point number 3, point number 3 in your notes there, it says, any sin is enough to condemn you to hell. So the fill in the blank is, any sin is enough to condemn you to hell. Letter A, it doesn't matter which sin you have or haven't performed, even one sin will send you to hell. Letter B, how this conversation may go. So the next verse that I take people to is James chapter number 2 and verse number 10. James chapter 2 and verse 10, the Bible says, for whosoever shall keep the whole law and yet offend in one point, he is guilty of all. And I'll just explain the verse and I'll say, you know, here the Bible is saying, if you were, hypothetically, if someone was able to keep the entire law, they followed everything except they made one mistake. They offended in one point. They told one lie. The Bible says it's as if he's guilty of all. And at this point, we're kind of concluding, the way that I give the gospel is kind of like the bad news and then the good news. The bad news is this, you're a sinner. You are condemned to hell because of your sin. The good news is you don't have to go to hell, but they need to understand the fact that they need a Savior in order for them to call upon the Savior. So we're explaining to them the fact that they're sinners. We're explaining to them the fact that there are wages for their sin, which is death. And I'll kind of just stop right here. I'll say, you know, up to this point, what I basically have showed you is that according to the Bible, every single person is condemned to hell because of their sin. And sometimes I'll even ask people, like, what do you think about that? You know, and most people are like, well, that's not good, you know? And then that'll kind of let me transition into, well, I have to give you the bad news before I can give you the good news, okay? The bad news is this, you're a sinner. And I kind of use this as a review, you know? I'll say, I have to give you the bad news before I can give you the good news. The bad news is this, you're a sinner. I'm a sinner. And our sin has condemned us to hell. The wages of sin is death. But you don't have to go to hell. And let me show you how the Bible says that you can avoid hell. So if you look at point number four there in page number 12, we kind of review the bad news. Letter A, we pay for our sin through death. We pay for our sin through death. Letter B, not just a physical death, but the second death. Not just a physical death, but the second death, which is being cast into the lake of fire. Letter C, according to the Bible, every person is condemned to hell because of their sin. According to the Bible, every person is condemned to hell because of their sin. Now, let me give you some things for those of you that were writing notes in your Bible. If you want to go back to Romans 6:23, go back to that passage, Romans chapter number 6 and verse 23, and write a number 3 in front of Romans 6:23, because that's the third passage that you're going to go to. So if you want to write a number 3 in front of Romans 6:23, and then next to Romans 6:23 or underneath Romans 6:23 or wherever you're doing it, write the reference Revelation 20, 14, and 15. Revelation 20, verse 14 and 15, next to or under Romans 6:23. Now, go to Romans 20, 14, and 15. And I'll try to slow down and give you some time to write. Go to Revelation 20, 14, and 15. And before or in front of Revelation 20, 14, and 15, write the number 4. That's the fourth reference you're going to go to. The number 4. And then next to Revelation 20, 14, and 15, or underneath Revelation 20, 14, and 15, you're going to write Revelation 21:8, because that's the next verse you're going to show them, all right? So you got your next reference there to help you out. So number 3 in front of Romans 6:23, with the next reference being Revelation 20:14 and 15, a number 4 in front of Revelation 20:14 and 15, with the next reference being Revelation 21:8, all right? So that's lesson number 5. So basically, again, just so you understand, we're personalizing it. So we introduced ourselves, we asked them about their salvation, we came to the point, the realization they're not saved, they whatever they're believing in is not the true gospel. We asked permission to give the gospel, they said yes, we explained them that they're unrighteous, they're not perfect, we explained them that we're all sinners and they're a sinner, we explained to them that there are wages for sin, which is death, which is hell, and we personalized it. Hey, look, even you're not good enough. If you've lied, you know, that's enough to send you to hell. Now, if you go to page number 13, lesson number 6, entitled The Gift, we can transition into the good news, okay? Now, I want you to understand something. The tendency with a lot of soul winners is to go straight to the good news, because that's exciting. That's what we like, right? You know, we want to talk about Jesus. We want to talk about forgiveness. We want to talk about this. But here's what you got to understand. And keep in mind, you know, it's taking me hours to explain, you know, go through all this and explain to you. This process takes 15 minutes, literally, at the door. If someone's, sharp, they're comprehending it, they're getting it. It doesn't take that long. It shouldn't take you 4 hours to go through this. I'm explaining it and giving you notes and all those things. But if you do a good job at explaining to someone that they're condemned to hell because of their sin, and they realize that, like they get it, they'll give you as much time as you need to explain the good news. I mean, you can hook them in. If they realize, wow, you know, I thought that going to church once a month was good enough to get me to heaven, and you just showed me that that's not it, you know? Now I want to know, well, what do I need to do to go to heaven? So if you do a good job with this first part, you can take your time and be real thorough with the second part. And a lot of times we miss out on people's because we don't ever get them to the place where they realize, I need to be saved. And we kind of just either ignore that or don't do a good job with that. And they never got to that place where they realized, oh, I need a savior. They're still thinking like, well, I'm good enough. I'm not a murderer. I'm not as bad as my neighbor or whatever. So as you transition to the good news, the gift, you want to make sure that you've done a good job at explaining to them that they're a sinner, condemned to hell, we're not beating them up and we're not telling them you're some wretched, filthy. We're not doing that. But we're just showing them. You're reading the verse, you're revealing the truth, you're reviewing the concept. Once they get it, once they grasp it, you move on to the next thing. So,